Hi, in this lesson, we are going to see how we can add CSS for our components in a storybook. So in our previous lesson, we wrote a component called car. We have the stories here, but as we can see, we can't really see any difference from the colors or the sizes. So the first thing that I'm going to do, remember our folder called styles that have the global CSS. I'm going to write a new file and don't really worry too much about the current state of this file. This is going to be just some design tokens, and we have a module that we will explain how to generate those. But right now, I'm just going to use three simple tokens. And because that doesn't really matter too much, I'm just going to copy and paste it. So as you can see, we have a first token called color primary, second one color secondary, and a third one called box shadow small. This is some values of a color. Finally, the box shadow is a simple box shadow. So then let's just write the CSS for the car and let's create a CSS file. I'm going to write the default styles for the car. I'm just going to define that this is flex. To be honest, I use a lot of flex. And then I'm going to set that the width is 100%. I want this to occupy the whole width of the screen. And then the align items is going to be center, because whatever it is inside the car, I want it to be centered. The padding is going to be just magic numbers, 12 pixels in the top at the bottom, and in the size is going to be 10 pixels. The border is just going to be a simple 1px solid, and the color is going to be transparent. And the border radius is going to be 10 pixels. The box shadow, remember our value of the token here, the box shadow is small, so I can copy this value and I can put it there. And because I have it, I don't need a default value in this case. Finally, I'm going to put some transition for the box shadow. So every time that I change my box shadow, it's going to have a nice animation. We are not going to really see this right now, but you will notice in the future. So this is the basic styles of the car. Let's start storybook so we can visualize how it looks. And of course, this only works if I have that class. So for that, it's very important that I set a class here. So if I put a class name to the car, class name car, another thing that we need to do is import our styles. For that, I'm going to just write the car CSS here. That should do the trick. Right now, you can see something changed, but not much. What we can do instead is change the border 1px solid transparent for tomato. So we can notice that something is there. So we have the border radius, we have the padding, we have the flex, of course. It's totally vertical center. That's okay. So in order to change the styles based on the props, if I want to see the primary or the secondary and the sizes, I'm going to use a nice utility called class names. So I'm just going to jar add class names. And this is going to be basically the only dependency of this project. Yes. Is basically that. The rest is going to be by ourselves. So I'm going to start Storybook again so we keep seeing the changes in real time. What I'm going to do right now is to write this in a different way. Instead of a hard code, the class name, I'm going to use class names here. For that, I need to use class names. And the first attribute is going to be car, because this one, of course, is going to apply for all the styles. So let's import class names from class names. Now we have the package. And what you can do with class names, you can pass an object as any argument. This order doesn't really matter. You can use the object first and the string later. It receives different types of attributes. So in this case, what I'm going to write here is this syntax. Remember, this is, by the way, this is JavaScript. So I'm going to put a class called color dash the color prop. This is going to be place only when color exists. And this is going to be the same for the size. So I'm going to write a new class called size, and only when size has a value. Because color is going to be have a value always that is going to be primary, by default, it's going to be color dash primary and size dash small. Now we need to write those classes in our CSS. So if we go to our CSS, I can write color primary. Let's write color primary. And in this case, the color is going to be white. But the background color is going to be our color primary. Remember that value that we have? And if I change this for secondary, and I change this for secondary, I'm going to have the same result. Something is happening here. I guess my problem, it might be the background, probably. No, I can't see really why it's not applying. Let's keep it as background and let's see what is really happening. Color primary, let's see if the token, oh yes, I know what is happening. Of course I am loading the tokens, right? Oh, and that's why we are also not seeing like the box shadow. I define the token, right? The token, and this should be called tokens. I think this is better if we call it tokens because it's of course a collection of tokens. So let's just rename it tokens. I have this file, this is a global file, but where is applied? Is the car loading it? No, the car is just responsible for load their own styles. Remember what we did before with the global styles? Yes, we also need to do this for the tokens because this is our global styles. So if I go to a storybook, go to preview, a part of the global style, we also need the tokens. And now that I put the tokens, now I can see how this is reflected. I can change this back to transparent. I can see a little bit. Maybe if I change the grid, it's very subtle, but there is a small box shadow here. So now I have the primary, secondary story, but now we have the same sizes. So let's do it for the sizes. It's the same, just size, small. So this is some kind of pattern that I like to use. It's classes based on props. It's similar to Tailwind CSS. I don't really use Tailwind CSS, but I really like the approach where you have a component and you put different classes and it changes how it looks. You have the base layer of the styles and then you can like toggle between the different styles. So in the case of size, this is going to be min high. For the small, I want 45 pixels. And then we have large. And for large, let's say large is 115 pixels. Now we can see the difference here. Of course, this looks pretty strange because we have it together. We also will fix that. So now that we have our styles for our third component and we can visualize the stories, let's see how we can use templates in a storybook in our next lesson. See you in the next one.